Yes, what a season. The Rebels won back-to-back home games for the very first time. They scored more tries than last year, conceded less tries, and many other stats are heading in the right direction as well. Now, to talk about the season just gone, would you please welcome your coach, Damien Hill, your captain, Stirling Mortlock, and your vice-captain, Gareth Dell. Welcome, folks. Damien, I know you haven't had much time to think about it because the season only ended not all that long ago in Cape Town, but how would you sum up the Rebels' second year?
Better. Still elements of frustration there, but better. I think, like you said, with the stats there, we conceded on average one try less a game. We scored more than 80 points more than we did last year. Seven of our matches we lost within a nine point band. But I think the frustrating part of that's probably, you could argue this, but four of those seven matches we were in the position, had the opportunities, we just weren't able to convert. So look, it's definitely a better season than last season. But I think if you talk to the playing group in general, they know they can do better, they want to do better, and they're really looking forward to next season.
Gareth, I have to ask you, what was it like being the only Welshman, the only Rebel supporting Wales in the three test series against the Wallabies last month?
I think you'd be surprised, Clarky. I think a few of the Kiwi boys were right behind us Welsh, and we're cheering on quite a lot. But now it's amazing to have that series and to be able to show the boys around, especially when we came down to Melbourne, sort of act as a bit of a tour guide in Australia for the Welsh lads.
And you got called back into the Welsh squad as well. Congratulations on that. And you did some commentary for BBC Wales. You did some commentary for BBC Wales, and family and friends back at home were giving you stick, thinking you're sounding like an Australian.
Yeah, they think I've picked up some of the accents and when I'm saying g'day on the phone and everything else. But I also had Cooper Vuna telling me that when I was spending time with the Welsh boys, I was starting to put on a Welsh accent as well. So I really can't win.
Yeah. All right. Well, Stirling, an emotional roller coaster for you over recent weeks, counting down to your retirement. Has it sunk in that your playing days are finally over?
It has. It was a bit weird, the fact that, I guess, my last home game, there was a fair bit of build up to that. And then, obviously, two matches in Africa. Couldn't have been happier besides getting a result. Playing against a lot of mates that I've played with against a lot of football, the Stormers. And, you know, they got me up on stage and actually presented me with a jersey and everything else. So it was a really nice way to finish up.
Now, Damien, it's been said that to be taken seriously in this competition, you have to perform well abroad, in New Zealand and South Africa. Do you think the Rebels turned the corner on the recent trip to South Africa?
It's definitely better, but I mean, that Lions match was a game we'd really targeted, and we ended up losing that by 6 points. Yeah, compared to our last trip of South Africa, a definite huge improvement. But yeah, we can do better and we will do better next year.
Hey, it's pretty hard to get this coach to be happy. Onwards and upwards. Gareth, I've said in commentary, and I'm not a member of your fan club, by the way, but I have said in commentary on a few occasions that you have been the best buy in this competition. Super Rugby has had a few duds, let me tell you. You've given your all for this young club. Is it safe to say you're having a ball with the Rebels?
Yeah, I've absolutely loved everything that has come over the last 2 years. Obviously, that was a huge part of the decision to stay for a third year. But the opportunities I've been given to be part of this team, part of this city, has been amazing. And, you know, I'm grateful to the likes of Hilly and Rod for the faith they've shown in me and learning off the likes of Stirling and Haas and those guys. And really buying into what we're trying to do in Melbourne and Victorian rugby has been easy because there's so much passion for the sport in this city.
Stirling, 15 seasons of Super Rugby. 15 seasons. If you say it quickly, it doesn't sound all that much. The first man to reach 1,000 points in Super Rugby. Your last two seasons have been with the Rebels, so how special have they been?
Oh, fantastic. This season, a little bit disappointing because I was injured for a fair amount of it. I guess the positive to come out from that was how well big deal. He did lead the team this year. And likewise, the other guys in the leadership group really stepped up. But coming to Melbourne, a new chapter for my family. We'll be living in Melbourne for the next couple of years as well. Couldn't have been happier. It's been fantastic. Every week I was constantly reminded that the decision to come down here was the right one. And it's been a fantastic journey the last 2 years.
Good on you. And Damien, later we're going to say farewell to a third of your squad who are retiring or moving on. So how hard will it be trying to fill those gaps?
It's not a third, is it?
It's a third. You got 30 in your squad. I know we've got five in the EPS.
Yeah, I think the average age of the team goes from 28 and a half down to about 24.
That's due to me, basically.
due to Stirling. We won't have next year our oldest player being the twice the age of our youngest player, which would be interesting. Look, it's very hard to replace that sort of experience, but you look to replace it with enthusiasm, and that's part of the selection process for the guys coming in. So, look, it is going to be different, but we have a number of senior players, experienced players still involved with the club, Gareth being one of them, and they'll have an increased responsibility in terms of leadership, but you know, it'll be an exciting time for the club. Good opportunities for some young talent.
And Gareth, where do you see this club in a few years' time?
I see massive things for the club and for the state. We've already seen, you know, a few of the young lads who've got Australian recognition from Victoria. And I'd love to see more Victorian local lads coming through, you know, through into the team. But, you know, I have the likes of Nick Phipps, Hugh Parle, Caden Neville, you know, even Kurt Lee, James, Luke Jones, all these guys around the age of 22 to 26, Laurie Weeks, they can become a huge part of this team, you know, the real spine of it for the next 5, 6, 7 years. And I think if we can keep those guys and we keep maintaining that development, we're going to be playoff contenders very, very soon.
Stirling, what about the future? What does it hold for you?
I'm still going to be involved with the club next year, so some ambassadorial sort of stuff, likewise helping out with Hilly and the coaching staff a little bit. But also, the last 2 years I've been involved with NAB MLC Group, and so looking to do some work with them as well.
Okay, and Damien, we have one Welshman. You had another person from the UK here as well, and Denny, but have you been fielding any phone calls on the back of Gareth's decision to stay and the success he's made of it?
From Danny?
No. From other possibilities?
There's been a lot of interest from overseas teams and overseas players, which has been great. I think that's a credit to, you know, what these two individuals and a lot of other players have built. Gareth alluded to, the success of this club is going to come off the back of Victorian players being developed and coming to this team. I think having homegrown players representing the Rebels is a key to the future of this organisation, and that's really one of our main focuses at the moment.